So let's take a look at sequences. Today we're going to study arithmetic sequences and summation. First of all, a sequence is a list of elements. Sometimes the elements are called terms. Okay, for example, here's a finite sequence. 1, comma, 2, comma, 3, comma, 4, comma, dot, 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 comma, 10. It goes from 1 up to 10. Finite means ending. So it has an end. Now, I could also show you an infinite sequence. For example, 2, comma, 4, comma, 6, comma, 8, comma, dot, dot, dot. No ending. Goes forever. Okay. Let's take a look at some notation. This is by far going to be the trickiest part about sequences and series, is getting used to the notation. Okay, so every time you have a term is going to be called a sub n. So here's the term, and then here's the formula. And then you have to plug in n's to make the terms. For example, find the first term. So that would be a number 1, a number 1. So I'm going to let n be a 1. So that means I have to take 2 times by 1 plus 3. So a sub 1 is equal to a 5. So the first term is 5. Okay, and now I have to find the 10th term. That would be a sub 10. Now for all you ugly writers out there, make sure that your a is big and your 10 is a subscript. These numbers have to be low. All the other numbers are big. Okay, I have to be able to tell a low number, a subscript, a regular number, or a superscript, an exponent. Okay, since n is a 10, let's go ahead and plug 10 into the n spot. So the formula says 2 times your n number plus 3. So the 10th term of this sequence must be 23. And that's how you deal with formulas. Okay, something else we're going to study here is recursive. Okay, whenever you see the word recursive, make sure you remember the word previous. Previous. So a recursively defined sequence is going to be a sequence that uses the previous term to find the next one. So you're going to use the previous term to find the next term. So you have to know the one before it to find the next one. Okay, by far, the trickiest part is going to be the notation again. So let's take a look at this here. B sub n, so that means term. That means term. So how do you find the term? If B sub n is the term, what's B sub n minus 1? So if that's n minus 1 is the one that comes right before it. So this is the notation for previous term. Previous term. Now the easiest way of handling these is to figure out what this is trying to say in English, and then I'll just follow those directions. So to find a term, I have to take the previous one and add 3. Okay, so to find a term, to find any term, you take the previous term and add 3. Okay, does that make sense? To find a term, I'm going to take the previous one and add 3. Now, they told you B number 1. They have to give you a start. So B number 1 is 4. All right, let's go for B sub 2. Let's go for the second term. Remember, to find the second term, take the previous one, take 4, and add 3 to it. That would make 7. Okay, once you translate this to English, the work is really easy. B sub 3, to find the third term, I have to take the previous one, take the second term, take 7, and add 3. And B sub 4, take 10, and add 3 to make 13. So to keep going, the directions here say just add 3. That's what that's saying. So what's the 100th term? Well, to find the 100th term, you would have to take the 99th term, which I don't know. Well, what's the 99th term? Well, to find that one, I'd have to know the 98th term. You could see why recursive is not going to be used a whole lot. It's not very powerful. Okay, summation. Okay, summation means to add or sum all the terms together. So I guess the first thing we would have to do is find all the terms, and then I could add them together. Okay? So this is how it's going to work. It's going to say right here, n equals, let's just say n equals 4, and then above that sigma sign, it's going to say something like 8. So what does that mean? The number that they put here, okay, this is the starting input, And then the number up here, this is the last input, And that's not necessarily the answer, that's just the input. Okay, here's some examples for us. Okay, so first of all, sigma means to add. So what I'm going to do is add a bunch of things together. Let's put some plus signs here for us. 1 is the starting input. Okay, so let's see. Let's just make a list here. Inputs. We're going to put in 1. We're going to put in 2. We're going to put in 3. We're going to put in all the way up to 5. 3, 4, 5. It's very important that you look at the starting number and the ending number for your inputs. Okay, let's put 1 in. What's 4 times 1? 4. Okay, plus. Remember, this is sigma. Now let's put 2 in. 2 times 4 is 8. Let's put 3 in. 3 times 4 is 12. 4 times 4 is 16. 5 times 4 is 20. Okay, now the answer is not finished until you sigma or you sum them. You have to add them all up. Okay, of course, without a calculator. Let's see. If I was going to do this a smart way, I'd say 8 and 12 makes a 20. 4 and 16 makes a 20. What's 20 plus 20 plus 20? 60. Okay, let's try it again. Here's the formula. And the inputs, maybe I'll just write this down one more time. Usually people don't write this, but sometimes it helps because the input, it doesn't start with 1. Look at that. It starts with negative 2. Negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1. How high do we go? All the way to 3. So these are all the inputs we have to put in. Okay, so let's start with negative 2. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4 minus 1 is a 3. Plus, please put in negative 1. 0 it is. Plus, please put in 0. Okay, negative 1. Please put in 1. 0 again. Please put in 2. That gives us 3. And please put in 3. 9 minus 1, 8. Okay, don't forget to sum. This is the list, but this is the summation sign, so we have to add them together and get 13. 13. Okay, let's do one more here. We have to make sure that we put in the right inputs. The inputs go from 3 up to 8. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, put in 3, please. 5. Please plug in a 4. 7. Please plug in 5. 9. Please plug in 6. 11. Please plug in 7. 13. Please plug in 8. 15. All right, try to add this up without your calculator. Maybe, you know, adding things a nice smart way would be a good idea. Survey says 60 again. Look at that, 60. Okay, let's continue on here. So now that you know what notation looks like a little bit, it's time to start talking arithmetic. Okay, you're going to be hearing two words a lot in this chapter, arithmetic, geometric. Arithmetic, an arithmetic sequence, is a sequence whose terms differ by a common difference. Okay? In other words, arithmetic means to add. Arithmetic. So you're going to add something. And then there's a common difference, and we call that common difference D. Okay. First thing we're going to do is look at the recursive formula, but we've already said recursive is not that powerful. When I say recursive, you think previous. Okay, so how are we going to find a term? Okay, you have to take the one right before it. So how do you say the previous term? What's right before a sub n? A sub n minus 1. So take the one right before it and add a d. Let's take a look at some examples here. Okay, is this sequence arithmetic? Okay, so what some people do is they just look at the terms, look at the terms. Sometimes they look over here because it might be easier. And I'm thinking that they're adding a 3. Let's just check. Is it like that for the entire sequence? Negative 6 plus 3. And then plus 3. Plus 3. Plus 3. What if it's 3, 3, 3, and then plus 2? I wonder if I'll trick you. It has to be plus 3, plus 3. Yes, this sequence is arithmetic. Find the D. I did find the D. The D is 3. So let's write a recursive formula. For this sequence, the formula is you take the previous term, take the one right before it, take A sub n minus 1, and add on how much? Add on a 3. This is the formula that goes with that sequence. Let's try another one. 48 to 24, 24 to 12, 12 to 6. Remember, arithmetic means to add. Yeah, this one's not arithmetic. This one is half, half, half. That is a totally different story. That's geometric. We're going to do that one tomorrow. Okay. Let's take a look at this arithmetic sequence. So this is kind of an ACT a lot. They give you a bunch of numbers. Can you tell what number is being added? Okay, that means arithmetic. Arithmetic. Okay, 1 plus 2, 3 plus 2, 5 plus 2. Okay, so D must be a 2. All right, let's go ahead and find those next three terms. 9, 11, and 13. Okay, that wasn't so bad. So this is the first term. I'm going to label this A sub 1. A sub 2, A sub 3, A sub 4. After you make a sequence, sometimes it's a good idea to just get in the hang of labeling A sub 6, A sub 7. Okay, find the 10th term. Okay, well, this is the 7th one. 8, 9, 10. Here's A sub 10. All right, so we're going to have to add some more. 2 more makes 15. 17, 19. The 10th term, A sub 10, is 19. Okay, now here's how you have to start thinking. How many total D's did you add from the first term? From the first term. Okay, so let's see. So we started here. The 1 was just a 1. But we added 2. We added 2. We added 2. So how many D's did we add? We added 1, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We had to add 2 9 times. 9 D's were added. 19. How come we didn't add 10 D's? Well, the answer to that is because the first term didn't get a D. The first term was 1. You didn't add 2 until you had to make the next one. So how many D's did we need to get to the 10th one? Only 9 D's. One less. In fact, let's write that down with a star. One less D. Okay, very important concept. We're going to make a formula out of that in just a second. Okay, so how would we get to the 26th term? Now, I don't want to do it the long way. I want to do it the shortcut way. To get to the 26th term, okay, we would need 25 D's. And D is what? D is 2. Okay, so our first term is 1. And then we would have to add 25 D's. So 25 times 2. Okay, so what is A sub 26 going to be? 51. 51. And knowing that shortcut is what's going to be the best way to do arithmetic. Let's do it again. I see 2, I see 12, 22. What are they adding? D equals 10. D is a 10. All right, find the next three terms. 42, 52, 62. Let's find the 10th term. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Do you guys want to do it the long way or the shortcut way? I'll show you both and you can see what you like. So if we added another 10, another 10, another 10, we're getting 92. But maybe we should do this the shortcut way. So let's start with 2. And then how many D's would we need to add? How many 10's to get to the 10th one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Only 9. We'd have to add 9 10's. So we'd have to add a 90, which makes 92. So A sub 10 is 92. How many D's? 9 D's. 9 D's. All right, let's see if we can do that trick again. To find the 17th term, I would start with 2. Start with your first one. And then how many D's would we need? Not 17. We would need 16 D's. And D is 10. So A sub 17 is going to be 162. Okay, do you see what we're doing here? How we're adding D, adding D, adding D? So let's make a formula out of that. How would we get to A sub 9? Well, you would start with A number 1. And to get to the 9th term, you don't need 9 D's, you need 8 D's. Let's do it again. How would you get to the 18th term? You would start with the first one, whatever it is, and then you would need 17 D's. How would you get to the 7th term of any random sequence? Well, you'd have to start with the first one, and you would need how many D's? Not 7, 6 D's. To get to the 67th term, start with the first one, whatever it is, and then add on 66 D's. Okay, when it says explicit, this is the one we're going to like, uses the first term. Okay, write a formula for a term. So A sub N, here's the formula. Anytime you want to find a term, you always start with the first one. And then you're going to add on some D's. How do you get to the nth one? How many D's are we going to need to get to the nth one? N minus 1, one less D. How do you write an explicit formula? Okay, so here comes the formula, A sub n. The first term is negative 10. Great, negative 10. And then we would need how many D's to get to N? N minus 1 times 8. And now comes the fun part, because we are going to have to simplify this formula. So what we're going to do here is distribute in the 8. 8n minus 8 plus negative 10 is minus 18. So whenever you have formulas like this, you're going to want to distribute them, simplify them, and then clean them up a little bit. Okay, let's do it again. Write an explicit formula. Okay, explicit formula means A sub N. They tell us the first one is 7, and then we're going to need N minus 1 D's. Now, D is negative 5. If I write it like this, that looks like minus. That is not correct. I'm not going to give you full points. I will have to take a point off. Even though you distribute it and you know it's multiplied, you need to tell us it's multiplied by encasing that negative sign in some parentheses. Okay? If you didn't do it with the 8, that would not technically be wrong. Okay? But with the negative, you do have to use them. So let's go ahead and distribute here. Negative 5n. I just like putting the letter first. plus 5 plus 7 is plus 12. Okay. So we're getting good at arithmetic sequences. All right. Is this sequence arithmetic? Well, let's see. What does it look like they're adding here? Sometimes the best way to do this is to take one term, take 26, and subtract the previous one. So that's 7. Now let's check. Is 19 plus 7 plus 7 plus 7? Is it constantly plus 7? Yes, it is. So yes, it's arithmetic. D is a 7. Okay, let's write an explicit formula. A sub n is, what's the first term? 19 plus n minus 1 times d, which is a 7. Let's go ahead and simplify our formula. 7n plus 12. Now, it's always a good idea to check your formula. Is this indeed the right formula? Well, let's see. 7 times 1 plus 12. If I put 1 in, does it make the first term? Oh, good. Okay, if I second enter, if I change 1 to 2, does it make the second term? This formula seems to be the right formula for this sequence. Okay, what did they want me to find? The 10th term? Okay, no problem. A sub 10, I'm just going to use my formula here to find the 10th term. So 7 times 10 plus 12, the 10th term must be 82. Once you have an explicit formula, you can find any term you need. All right, I'm going to do that same thing again. I'm going to take the second term. I'm going to take negative 14.1, and I'm going to subtract the previous one, negative 11. So I'm thinking that the D is negative 3.1, but I have to check. Is negative 11 plus that D value, negative 3.1? Okay, that works for the second term. Let's add on a negative 3.1. Makes this the third term. All right, I got it. The D is negative 3.1. So yes, D is negative 3.1. All right, once you know the first term in the D, you can make a formula. A sub n is. How do you start? Well, at the beginning, of course. The first term, negative 11. Then you're going to need how many D's to get to n? N minus 1 D's, let's use parentheses, negative 3.1. So the formula is negative 3.1N. And then negative 11 plus 3.1 is minus 7.9. There it is. I have a formula. Let's check this formula because I want to get an A. So if I take negative 3.1, and I plug in 1, minus 7.9. If I put 1 in, does it make my first term? Good. Second enter. I'm going to put in a 2. Yep, it's making the second term. Okay, and they want me to find the 10th term. Okay, I will go here, and I will put in a 10. A sub 10 is negative 38.9, the 10th term. Okay. We have one more example here. Negative 10 to 2. Let's see. 2 minus negative 10. So it looks like this went up 12. Did this go up 12? Did that go up 12? All right, we got it. D is 12. A1, well, A1's negative 10. A sub n formula. How do you write a formula for a sub n? You take the first term, negative 10, plus n minus 1 times d. For this problem, d is a 12. So the formula is 12 n minus 12 minus 10 is minus 22. Let's find the 100th term. Well, first I want to make sure that I have the right formula. 12 times 1. Minus 22. If I put in a 1, does it make my first term? If I put in a 2, does it make my second term? Okay. If you're running out of time, you don't have to check, but this formula is definitely making all my terms. They want me to find the 100th term? Not a problem. I will just change 3 to 100. 12 times 100 minus 22 is 1178. Arithmetic sequences.